kicked it center by Middleton, but it comes free. Jonathan Drouin in for the Canadiens. Plays cross ice. Monahan a shot. That's kicked to the corner by Fleury. Joel Armia tried to feed the line. Intercepted by Kaprizov. Sends it ahead for Middleton. Middleton in. Cuts to the net and a save by Allen.
See that every day, but this is exactly what Dean Evason wants. If you've got a chance to jump up into the play, do exactly that. The big guy, a little disappointed he didn't maybe hit the far side of the net, but he looked like he knew what he was doing.
After Minnesota held him to one, Armia works out of the corner with it. Plays it cross ice, a sliding stop by Fleury.
Here early, a one-timer pushing across. Looks like he's seeing the puck very cleanly.
Kaprizov plays it around for Dumba, centered for Zuccarello. Got the heel of the stick on it, but couldn't redirect. Dumba back in behind. Kaprizov out from behind the net, and Allen makes the save.
Last season where he picked the puck up on his forehand and was able to wrap it.
Centering pass by Gouley. He goes off the pad of Fleury. Picked up by Anderson. He goes into the corner with it. A centering pass for Gallagher. And he's denied by Fleury again. Fleury has always had Brandon Gallagher's number. Doc carries up high. Suzuki trying to spin away from Spurgeon. Centers. Rossi had Caulfield tied up, and Fleury had to make a stop.
I'm sure if you're Marc-Andre Fleury, you're thinking to yourself, okay, one of his tendencies is that he is never going to pass the puck, and that's why he's going to be one of the best goal scorers this game has seen. He's just he's a very driven player, and he shoots at everything.
Allen out to play it. Gallagher bumped by Merrill. Wild just onside at the line. Eriksson Ekeskjold, save Allen. Shaw scores!
We talked about the Wild keeping their same game simple. This is exactly what I'm talking about. Just get the puck to the net, play north-south hockey, and Jake Allen misplays the puck, yes, but when you've got the mindset of just getting to the net and playing north-south hockey, it puts so much pressure on your opponent. Mason Shaw is able.
Armia spins away from Dumba. Armia moves in, a shot! It's deflected and then swept away by Duhaime.
Yeah, Armia with a great play to spin away from Matt Dumba. He gets to the front of the net here, and he clips Marc-Andre Fleury, who is inside his paint, and that's an easy call for the referee that was only 15 feet away. But
Kaprizov for Zuccarello, and the Wild gain the zone. Knocked down by Eriksson Ek at the line. Centering pass, they score! Oh, it's waved off. Kaprizov's deflection. I think this caught the back of the net. The officials have waved it off, but I think this is a goal for Kaprizov. It caught everybody by surprise.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you could just tell. You could tell it was the sound, even from up here in the press box. And I can tell you, goal scorers, they know when they've scored. And the way Kirill reacted to that play there, you knew that he had redirected that up into the upper corner. And there's no question. That's going to be another power play goal for this Minnesota Wild team.
Boldy moves down low. Out to Addison. He gives to Zuccarello. Zuccarello looking. Centers. Allen with a save. Loose puck, and it's punched wide by Kaprizov.
They've been able to keep four players' opponents on the ice for 90 seconds to a minute. I can't tell you how much that affects the other team's players.
Brodin driving in. Allen holds his ground. Armia able to clear for Montreal. Monahan to Savard. And now Jost has it. He goes cross ice. Kaprizov knocks it out of the air. Kaprizov, one and Rossi. They score! Marco Rossi should pick up his first NHL point. He knocked it out of midair on the feed from Kaprizov, and it's 3-0 Minnesota.
Rossi here, great play by Tyson Jost, getting it through the traffic on the other side. Look at the hands here by Marco Rossi. Puck up in the air. Ooh, they're going to take a look at that one right there. Again, he's able to knock it out of the air and get it back over to Kaprizov. It's the shoulders, not the
not the crossbar, it's the shoulders of the player. The puck has to be below. He is hunched down a little bit, Marco Rossi. The rule is if the player is just standing straight up and down, wherever that player's shoulder is. And what do you think, Anthony? That was pretty close again.
Zuccarello moves in. Boldy in the slot, looking. Kaprizov fire, saved by Allen. Zuccarello on it. Hands it to Boldy, halfway through the power play. Kaprizov fire, saved by Allen. Rebound, Eriksson Ekholm, two whacks.
Canadians, nice play here by Boldy. We talk about his ability to make all kinds of play, and Joel Eriksson Ekholm right in front with one, two, three whacks at it, and Allen makes a gigantic save and gets his glove on top of that, but the Wild's power play is going to get a chance to stay on the ice.
Long shot by Jack Guy, knocked into the corner. 2 minutes to go in the period. Centering pass, Fleury out to deny with a big pad stop. Steele has it at center. Wild coming into this game 4-1-1 in their last six. The Canadians coming in on a two-game win streak. But it was all Wild in the second period. Kaprizov. Center, Zuccarello deflects. Brodin has it. Back to Zuccarello. Kaprizov moves into the slot off the post. Looking for his third of the night. Two goals already. Looking for the hat trick. Catches iron.
Getting your two best defensive defensemen out on the ice against the five forwards is high-end stuff. And great to see.
Sliding stop by Fleury against Caulfield. Caulfield, Suzuki, Dock, Weidman to Caulfield, back to Weidman, Dock with it, center, Suzuki scores, and the power play goal for Montreal has them on the board with 6.5 to go.
In their last three games, when the first 8 or 9 games of the season, they only had one power play goal, so their coach, Marty St. Louis, making some adjustments. Nice play here by Doc to get that inside to Suzuki. And
let's see now. Here's Gallagher, denied by Fleury. And his mastery of Gallagher continues. Including this one against Gallagher to keep the lead at 2. Empty net for Montreal as Duer gets it out to center ice. Duer, Boldy, and Eriksson Ekholm, the three forwards for Minnesota in this spot. Spurgeon takes a shot at the empty net. It'll be well wide. Icing waved off, however. Duer to Boldy, and he scores!
That there's about as unselfish of a play as you're going to see on an empty net goal. Back to his backhand and just shoveled it into the empty net. Boldy just jumps into the small little area there and he says, thank you very much.
That's a play by Jared Spurgeon, knowing that he had a player that had a step and was going to be able to avoid the icing call.
Well, it doesn't surprise me at all with Jared Spurgeon, the way he plays. You know, sometimes having those type of players on the ice can nullify that, but what a great homestand here. The Wild in the first period, off shot 15-7.